I'm Julia, and welcome to Coffee Kouventa with Dear Danae, a chat between friends in response to percolating questions submitted to Danae by you, fellow Greek Australians who have contacted Danae to find out more about the Greek citizenship process. Also, to discover more about Danae's ebooks, Guide to Your Greek Citizenship by Descent and Guide to Deferring Your Greek Army Service Indefinitely. Each Coffee Kouventa will focus on one person who has reached out to Danae for direction and information. Yasu, Danae.
Yasu, Julia.
Now, dear Danae, I understand that after publishing your ebooks on Kobo, Apple Books, and Amazon, and then being on the front page of Neos Cosmos newspaper, you were inundated with emails from people wanting to know more about obtaining Greek citizenship by descent.
Absolutely, Julia. But I managed to apply to every single person. Then I thought it would probably be a really good idea to share these Q&As with everyone else wanting to know more about becoming a Greek EU citizen.
That sounds like a great idea to me. Well, let's get started. I have an email here from Mr. Peter N, and he writes, "Dear Danae, just wanted to touch base with you to find out the steps of obtaining our Greek citizenship. My wife has an expired Greek passport. We would really appreciate your feedback."
Hi, Peter N. Firstly, thank you for writing in. Regarding the steps and stages to Greek citizenship, as you can imagine, it's a pretty megalo topic. So I'll talk about the overall stages of the Greek registration process. From my experience, I found that there are six stages in obtaining Greek EU citizenship. These are: stage one, gather the documents that you need for your citizenship application. Now, these documents include your consulate or embassy documents and your personal verification documents. Stage two, submit your citizenship application and supporting documents to the relevant decentralized administration, or DA, in Greece. Your consular authority or Greek lawyer can transmit these for you. Stage three, the DA in Greece checks over your application and documents. Then it drafts a decision approving the application. Then it forwards the draft decision with the application and documents to the Ministry of Interior or the Department of Internal Affairs, which will formally approve the application for citizenship. Stage four, the DA receives the final decision from the Ministry of Interior, completes the final draft of the decision approving the application, and probates it in the State Gazette. Stage five, after the probate finishes, the Ministry of Interior authorises the DA to register the applicant in the municipal rolls. The DA then orders the relevant municipal office to register the applicant. Stage six, final stage, once you are registered on the municipal rolls, you may then get your Greek birth certificate, which allows you to then get your taftotita, or Greek ID card, and your diabetirio, or Greek EU passport.
So, Danae, this is just an outline of the six stages. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right, Julia.
Obviously, there are steps within these stages, such as preparing your personal verification documents for Greece. Danae, do you cover lots of information on the steps and stages in Guide to Your Greek Citizenship by Descent?
Absolutely, Julia. This book includes every actual step that we took for our sons to become Greek EU citizens. There's a detailed timeline of exactly everything we did, every step of the way from start to finish. And it will give you a really great understanding of what to do from a family who has completed the process. And also, it will tell you how we handled the challenges that popped up along the way.
Yes, and Guide to Your Greek Citizenship by Descent is an easy to read, easy to follow, comprehensive resource, and it's available on Kobo, Apple Books, and Amazon. Just search for Greek Citizenship or Danae Konidaris and the ebook will appear. And there you'll find out more about the guide and what's in it. There's also a sample chapter.
And back to Peter N's question, regarding your wife's expired passport, Peter, just letting you know that although her passport has expired, she does still remain a Greek citizen. When my husband's Greek passport expired a few years ago, the first thing that he did was to make an appointment with the Consulate General of Greece in Melbourne. And I recommend that you do this soon because usually there are quite lengthy wait times for consular appointments. Then my husband took to the appointment a copy of his confirmation of birth certificate, or you could take an actual birth certificate. He took his expired Greek passport, his Australian ID, preferably Australian passport, and two passport size photos from Australia Post for the new Greek passport. Now, Peter, your wife needs to provide documentation like a Greek birth certificate that can enable the consulate to find her in the Greek system using her municipal registration number. They don't need to be current certificates. They just need to have the municipal registration number on them. Your wife's taftotita or Greek ID card, if she has one, would also be excellent to take because it has her citizen registration number on it. Now, after my husband provided the documents I just mentioned, the Consulate General of Greece in Melbourne did the rest. So to Peter and all of you watching this video, I hope this information has helped you so that you may achieve what you want more easily.
And if you enjoyed this video, please take a moment to like this post and follow, that's right, Danae's Greek Citizenship by Descent page on Facebook. This will keep you in the loop with more Kopi Kouventa videos and posts on becoming a Greek EU citizen coming soon. Na iste kala, Danae. Thank you and ευχαριστώ for sharing these insights with everyone.
Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ, Julia, for hosting my Kopi Kouventa today. Να είστε όλοι καλά. Αντίο.
Αντίο, Danae.